Welcome to this screencast where we're going to talk about using the HPE CSI driver for Kubernetes to perform dynamic provisioning of persistent storage. My name is Michael Mattson. I'm a tech marketing engineer with Hewlett Packard Enterprise. Before we dive in, I want to walk through a few PowerPoint slides here on how dynamic provisioning for Kubernetes works and use a few, kind of just showcase a few of the API objects that we work with when provisioning persistent storage for Kubernetes. Imagine for a second that we have a Kubernetes cluster with any of the entry storage plugins. We're using a cloud provider or any vendor's CSI driver. And you have a number of different API objects at your disposal. The first thing that you need to declare in a cluster is something called a storage class. A storage class is implementation specific, whether you're using a cloud or a CSI driver or anything of sorts, right? You need to have like something that describes like the provisioner name and the different parameters that are specific for that provisioner. The next thing you would use is something called a persistent volume claim. And this is kind of where the end user comes in, where he declares his needs for his application, right? So in this particular case here, the user requests a 100 gig volume and it requests that from a particular storage class. If the cluster has a default storage class name on the cluster, you don't have to declare the storage class. You also specify the access mode. Since we're using the HPE CSI driver, which is a block storage plugin, we're going to use read-write once. Once you've declared a persistent volume claim on the cluster, the dynamic provisioner will listen for that particular event and basically create a new persistent volume that matches the storage class. So the storage class is sort of like a cookie cutter template, right? And the persistent volume in itself describes something called what we would call a external volume. Once that external volume has been declared on the cluster, what Kubernetes does is basically binds the volume, the persistent volume with the persistent volume claim. And at this stage, the volume will be ready for use by the user, so the user can reference the persistent volume claim from his particular workload. So I'm switching over to my terminal here, and I'm just going to show you that we have the HPE CSI driver already installed. I haven't declared any storage classes, or I don't have any way to reference my backend storage system yet, but we're going to create those objects. So I'm first going to do just a helm list namespace kube system -o YAML to show you that the driver is already installed. Next, we need to declare something called a secret. The secret basically just references the backend storage system that I have in my lab. It contains the username, password, and things like that to allow me to create persistent volumes from that system. The next thing, I need to create a storage class. So this storage class basically references the secret I just created. I'm going to give it a name. I want to make it the default storage class, so all my users' persistent volume claims will be declared against this class. I want to allow volume expansion, as I want to show you how that works as well. And there are some other CSI provisioner specific things here that I want to create an XFS volume, and I want to specify certain mount options for the volume. The next thing I'm going to do is create a persistent volume claim. In this particular case, I'm going to create a 32 gig volume, access mode read-write once, and no extra flavor, extra colors, extra declarations. This is just, I'm just asking the cluster for a 32 gig volume. Creating the persistent volume claim is a pretty quick operation, right? So you can immediately see that the volume has been bound. We have a physical volume that is being referenced from our persistent volume claim. I named data, and my volume is PVC and the long UUID that we can see here. The next thing I'm going to declare is a workload. So this is a single replicate deployment. It's using a very simple command called IOPing, and it basically just like checks, does an IO to a mount point or a block device or a file or anything like that. But the default behavior of this particular instance of IOPing, as it will simply do an IO ping on the slash data mount point, right? So we're going to see that in the logs afterwards. And you can also see here that I'm referencing from my container spec here a volume mount that references my persistent volume claim that I've named data. I'm just going to wait for the pods to come up, and then we're going to see what's going on inside that particular pod. There we go. Now I'm going to get the logs from this pod and see what the container is doing. We can see here that the IOPing application is issuing 4K IOs on the slash data mount point. And we can also see that, oh, this is an XFS file system. It's referencing a multipath device of 32 gig. And that kind of matches what I've asked the cluster to provision for me. So we're all good here. I'm also going to show you how to resize or more or less expand a volume. There's no shrink, there's only expand, right? So we can see here that, all right, I'll do a kubectl exec, and I can see that my multipath device is indeed 32 gigs. And then I'm just going to edit the PVC. And you can go down to the spec and you look at resources, request, storage. It's the 32 gig at the moment. And if I set that to 64 gig, the CSI resizer will call the HPE CSI driver to resize the backend volume and then go over to the CSI node driver to do a volume expansion. And we can already see that the PVC has been expanded, and we should then be able to do a kubectl exec inside our deployment again and see that the file system has actually been expanded. And there we go, 64 gig. And as a responsible Kubernetes user, I'm just going to clean up after myself. If you're interested in learning more about HPE storage and the HPE CSI driver for Kubernetes, visit hpe.com/storage/containers. See you next time.